es muy linda.
Buenos Aires is the capital city of a country called Argentina. Argentina is located in South America. To give you all some perspective, Ohio is located right here. Buenos Aires is close to the ocean, so that means there's a lot of ships that come into this region to transport goods for trading. This means that Buenos Aires is known as a port city. Because of this, the people of Buenos Aires are called porteños. Buenos Aires is a very unique city because in the late 1800s and early 1900s, lots of immigrants from Europe came to this area. Most of these immigrants were from Italy. And because of this, you can see lots of Italian influence all throughout Buenos Aires. One example of the traces that the Italians left behind was the language. People from Buenos Aires speak Spanish, but they have a slang that's called lunfardo. Lunfardo is a fusion of Hispanic and Italian words. Lunfardo was originally only used among Italian criminals in Buenos Aires, but now it's become common among all people of Buenos Aires, especially the younger generation. One of the most popular words in Buenos Aires is che. No one really knows the origin of the word che, but it means a couple different things. It can be used as friend, so hola che would be hello friend. It can also be used as an interjection like hey to get someone's attention. The food in Buenos Aires has a European twist. You won't find a taco here. Much of the food in Buenos Aires is Italian. Pastas and pizzas are common staples. Empanadas, which are savory pastries filled with cheese and meat, are also widespread. Buenos Aires is also known for their succulent steaks. Supposedly the meat tastes different over there because the cattle are given plenty of room to roam and they're fed grass instead of corn like they are here in the United States. Another popular meat is called chorizo. It tastes like a spicy sausage. Many times chorizo is served on bread, like a hot dog. This is called choripan. The chori stands for chorizo, the meat, and pan is the word for bread. All throughout Buenos Aires, you'll probably find a lot of asados, which are grills where they grill meat. For breakfast, many Argentinians will eat something called a media luna. It's a type of sweet pastry. It's called media luna because it literally means half moon, and the shape looks like half of a moon. So what types of drinks are common in Buenos Aires? The most common drink by far is a type of tea called mate. Mate is served in a glass that looks like this. Most people drink mate with their friends, passing the cup around to each person so that they can have a little sip. Mate originated with the countrymen of Argentina, who were also called gauchos. The gauchos were kind of like our American cowboys. They lived in the countryside and raised cattle. The drink originated among them, but soon it became widespread among all Argentinians. Now, mate is seen as a cultural symbol of Argentina. If you go to Argentina, I'm sure that someone will try to become friends with you and talk to you over a drink of mate. So after eating a meal, Argentinians have lots of energy to have fun. So what are some things that Argentinians do in their free time? Argentinians love to dance. The tango is one of their most popular dances. It was originally seen in a negative light because it was performed by poorer people in shady parts of the city. However, the tango quickly became popular not only throughout Buenos Aires and Argentina, but also worldwide. The tango is a dance of passion, characterized by swift movements and fancy footwork. In Buenos Aires, many tango dancers perform on the streets for spectators to see. It's common for young adults in Buenos Aires to go to clubs to dance with their friends. They oftentimes dance into the wee hours of the morning and even later. I was surprised to learn that it's common for people in Buenos Aires to get home from dancing when people in America would be waking up. People in Buenos Aires are also loco or crazy for football. Football, or football, in Buenos Aires in Argentina refers to soccer. Many friends get together to watch the games, and they like to play the sport amongst themselves. People in Buenos Aires are also very family-oriented. Family means a lot to them, so they try to spend as much time as possible with loved ones. When people in Buenos Aires aren't spending time with their family, they might be strolling through town looking for interesting shops or cafes. Some people enjoy going to an area called La Boca, which is a touristy place that sells arts and crafts. It's famous for its multicolored buildings. After all, in a city of more than 2 million people, it's impossible to be bored. There's plenty to do, see, and eat. So I hope you all learned something interesting about Buenos Aires today. Hasta luego.